eyes that it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you.
In this particular event, the object and its entire ionization trail vanished at the same instant. When I thought about that, it occurred to me the only way that you could accomplish that is if you are somehow modifying time itself.
Right.
If you're able to make time jump forward, say, 10 or 15 seconds, it wouldn't seem like that big of an impact in the overall scheme of things. And I questioned whether that was actually possible. But about the same time, there was another researcher who I had occasion to befriend, was talking to Dr. Fred Bell, who is now deceased. But Dr. Fred Bell was living in Laguna, California, and he had been sort of cherry-picking details from some of his own aerospace contacts about some of these advanced technology propulsion systems, what they might look like, how they might operate, and he had built an apparatus in his backyard in Laguna. It probably looked a little bit like the first telecommunication satellite, which we call Telstar, from the 1960s. Sort of a polyhedron, you know, almost like a very small version of a geodesic dome, except in a sphere-shaped. It had a number of lasers and triangular panels on the outside, and each one of these panels was a stack of electrically conductive plates. They were capacitors, plate capacitors, kind of like the ones that you see in these little lifter designs that people build that levitate and so forth. But they're all pointing inward. And he had a window in this thing. And he was using some very high voltages. I believe he was using something like a Tesla coil to charge up these capacitors on the exterior of this device. And so late one night, when there was very little activity around the neighborhood, he fired this thing up, and as he was sitting inside of it, he looked out the window, and there was a stretch of Pacific Coast Highway that ran past his backyard, where cars would go by at between 45 and 60 miles an hour. And the moment that he fired this thing up, the vehicles that had been speeding by his backyard slowed to a snail's pace, just instantly slowed down to a crawl. Now, a lot of people don't know this, but when your car is running, the alternator is putting out pulses of electricity, and there's a rectifying circuit in the alternator that creates direct current, so that it's all flowing in one direction, but the pulses are still there. So your headlights, even though you don't see it, you don't perceive this, your headlights are flashing on and off at a very high pace, probably somewhere between 30 and 60 cycles per second. And so because your eyes are not able to detect intervals of that short amount of time, you don't see the flashing. But because this apparatus that he had built was somehow modifying time, it was almost like what they call a time dilation effect, where you're basically condensing a tremendous amount of activity. In other words, what's going on inside of his little vehicle that he's built. You're condensing a tremendous amount of time into a short time span, as viewed from the perspective of someone who's standing outside the disturbed region of space-time immediately surrounding this vehicle. So the average person is driving along in the car, they don't see or feel anything. But he's looking out the window, and this car that's going by 65 miles an hour suddenly is moving at the pace of a snail, and he can literally see the headlights coming on slowly and then fading to black and then coming on again slowly. So he can actually see the pulses of the headlights as these things begin to move by. And he realized that he had actually created an event where he was able to modify the pace of time within the little region of space in the immediately surrounding this apparatus that And so when I thought back to this cigar-shaped thing moving across the sky, instantly disappearing along with its entire ionization trail, I began to realize that maybe it is in fact possible to modify time, not just the pace of time, but actually from moment to moment. And so then I extrapolated that even further. I began to realize, okay, if you've got a vehicle that has this ability and you decide that you you're going to go floating across the landscape, and you get to a certain point, you stop, and you decide, oh, I'm going to go off in another direction. To someone who's standing back from that event, it may look as though you zipped across the landscape and made a right angle turn at over 9,000 miles an hour, because you have condensed a tremendous amount of activity down into a very short interval of time, as perceived by everybody else. And this may also explain why there's no supersonic shockwave, because the air that's surrounding the vehicle sees that same modified pace of time, and so it doesn't experience some energetic transfer of energy from the surface of the vehicle as it's being displaced. It's entered into that same sort of local space-time environment where time is moving along at a different pace. And so even though you seem to be moving along in a very relaxed manner, you stop, make a turn, and go off another direction, the air flows around the vehicle. But once it exits that disturbed region of space-time, it reacquires its interaction with the local environment, and that's where you get the glowing trail, because all those particles that are moving through that little dynamically engineered local space-time, as they call it, they begin to reacquire their interaction with the local environment, and it actually causes the individual molecules there to sort of jump back to their steady state and even sort of bounce beyond that moment or that particular state. And so they re-radiate the excess energy as photons. So you see this ionization trail as something you may not even perceive as you're moving along casually in your flying saucer or some other vehicle that has this capability. So it may be that they're not only modifying space-time, but they're actually modifying the pace of time within that framework.
That's incredible. That really is. And that like as you've just pointed out, could be a plausible reason, as you say, why they can do these maneuvers that they can do. And but that gets, and again, that opens up a whole set of questions, doesn't it, in the sense of the aspect of time travel.
Well, not just that, but it also explains missing time. Can say, I've been abducted by aliens and I had an hour of missing time. Now, I thought all of that was a bunch of baloney. I mean, in the beginning, I thought, you know, these are people who have issues and they're, you know, seeking attention. They want to tell a tall story and get on TV.
Some could be, but not all.
Well, and I'm sure that's probably true in some instances. But, you know, the next thing that occurred to me after I had convinced myself, based on everything I was seeing, that the technology was real and that these things really do exist, because I had gone out and waited and looked. Thank you.
us.